Welcome to ETAP webinar, Short Circuit and Dynamic Modeling of Inverter-based Resources. My name is Mohammad Zadeh. I'm a Senior Vice President of Protection and Control at ETAP. In this webinar, first we look at the fundamentals of inverter operation and control. Then we look at the proper selection of ETAP IBR models and tools that support inverter-based resources. As part of this discussion, we also look at our objectives, that what type of studies we do. And finally, I'll summarize this webinar. Grid following is an inverter that requires another voltage source in the system to operate, while grid forming can work independently without any source in the system. Now, in the grid support, typically, there is a active power and frequency control, means that if the frequency deviates from a nominal frequency, similar to generators, we want to have some sort of a droop to adjust the active power. Okay, if the frequency drops, you want to inject more active power. If increases, you want to inject less. The major difference between the smart inverter and regular inverter is that the classical inverter is like a generator. If you have a P and Q, it's going to have a fixed P and Q. Or if you have a P versus voltage, it's going to have a fixed P versus volt and voltage set points, or P and power factor. But in a smart inverter, you have a curve that you define that how the reactive power should be with respect to voltage. Let's say this is a volt var control. Now, there is a reactive power priority, active power priority, and user-defined power factor. It's very important to select the right one. If you're dealing with a small inverter, residential, if this is not for a big plan, typically these are user-defined power factor or real power priority. If you have a system with a bunch of IBRs, with a bunch of reactive power resources, and you have either power plant controller or mercury controller, it's important to model those. So when you want to see the impact of those controllers on your renewables.
Join us this week, Wednesday, August 11th or August 12th, to watch the full technical webinar on short circuit and dynamic modeling of IBRs. Go to etap.com/webinars to register.